Love this podcast? Support it and sponsor today. Simply head to OzCastNetwork.com for details.
Hey Adelaide, it's your boy Con from Blind Trophy Centre.
You ready, mate?
Party people!
And now it's time, live from the Oscar Studios, it's Best Team Men.
Let's go.
Oh, yeah. It is the remix of Best Team Men. Andy Martin, Jarrah Walsh, Matty Burgess, he's in here. So we're welcoming a radio legend in Adelaide and Australia. And like they say and have put on a T-shirt, everything's always better with Rosie Panetta.
You say that even though I'm pretty sure I jinxed the last
episode. We don't talk about that because you know what, Rosie? Okay. What we thought we'd do,
because
Monday was International Women's Day, so we had an idea of maybe bringing you in on International Women's Week, and what a great idea it was.
Okay, I need to talk about last week's episode because I suggested that.
Didn't happen. Okay. Where's the proof? We walked away going, that was a really good episode, and obviously we send in love to Matty Burgess. We don't know whether he's going to be back or not. He's out indefinitely. With an injury, so that's okay. But that's what happens in sport. It just says indefinite, so we're just waiting to hear what's going on. But to have you here, Rosie, it's great because a lot of people know who you are, but for the people who don't, obviously, you've got a brilliant history so far in radio. You're a game day presenter at the Port Adelaide Football Club. You've also got the podcast on the Ozcast Network called I've Eaten Something Bad Now, I've Got Gastro, whatever it's called.
That's actually a combination of your podcast, I Hate to Win. Yeah, and okay, now I'm hungry, which is amazing.
Two things I love to do, eat and whinge. But I have, Best Team Men, are we changing the title, mate? Because
It's a working title, Emma. That's why it's the remix today.
Woman.
Yeah, it's the remix version today. But we do appreciate having you on. I want to give a quick synopsis of what people are going to hear over this podcast because we know it's recording. So we're gonna talk about radio ratings very soon because we always have a little bit of a media chat because we're all from radio. So
Have they come out?
Yeah, they came out today.
I've been out of radio for a bit, guys.
We don't have to deep dive in it. It's just I think we should share some stories about radio ratings. I had one of the most horrific moments of my life last week, which is, it's not funny, but you guys will laugh in a, wow, I can't believe you did that.
That was a wow in itself.
I've never been asked back to SeaWorld.
it was an enema as well.
We got a radio fail, some stuff from Andy Martin. The Shifty sound has blown up online. So that's brilliant. And two games. There's a game you guys don't know about today, as well as Back to the Future game. I'm going to introduce the game, which I just thought of earlier.
I forgot that happens. I forgot to do my research about Spice Girls and Backstreet Boys.
You'll find out. So, Rosie, what can you tell us about yourself for people who don't know you but recognise your voice?
Oh, do they recognise my voice?
Yeah.
It's been out of action for a while.
Well, you've spoken for longer than 12 seconds, which is a rarity because that's what I used to do on radio.
Not longer.
Gosh, I don't know. Where do you want me to start? I don't know. How much do you want to hear about me?
Well, people would mostly recognise you recently from Nova, right?
Yeah,
which threw me in the bin like a piece of rubbish last September. And I haven't really wanted to talk about myself since then.
I'm here.
I'm with my two favourite former colleagues.
Yeah, well, we're current colleagues at the moment because we're doing this podcast.
Okay, yeah, let's talk present tense. My favourite colleagues.
Yes.
In the only workplace I know.
Right. Correct.
Don't expect to get paid.
What do you want to know?
So, okay, let's ask a couple of radio things because we did that in the last episode, which didn't record. We don't need to talk about that anymore. Great episode, though. Kyle Chalmers loved it, Andy.
Thank you.
I want to ask, have you missed the time away from radio, or do you think there has been parts that have been beneficial to be outside of the radio bubble to give you some perspective on life?
A bit of both.
Yep.
Like, I'm not going to lie, the past 6 months have been pretty rubbish.
Mm.
And I don't talk about the redundancy much because it still makes me pretty upset and I don't want to bring down this.
You can say whatever you want, mate.
Yeah.
And get sad. No,
we're not a funny podcast, so you can say whatever you like.
We're open and honest.
It's been great to have lots of time with my husband, who I...
He's hot as well, making babies.
He's a very good-looking bloke.
Real hot.
He's,
I know. Hairy arms, but that's okay.
No, he's working on it. I booked him in for some laser hair removal. So, I mean, always... So great. He's back to perfect.
And then the surprise thing is you're doing the removal with the laser? Hey, babe.
So that's been good, and hanging out with the Queens, because I obviously had like 8 years of long distance because of radio. So I went away through pretty much my... Since I was an adult living out of home, I've been moving around the country to pursue radio and then to finally get back home and have like a normal life for like less than 2 years, and then it gets thrown out. Obviously, it was really shit. So it's been nice to kind of like catch up with Christopher. Like, that's been the silver lining.
Get to know your husband.
Yeah, I mean, I knew him. I didn't just marry him after 13 years. I know much. But so that's the silver lining. I guess it's been a bit rubbish because it's weird to try and find a life after radio because it's a very niche skill set. And I'm like, what do I do?
Yeah, you're what in the Wild West.
What do I do now? Mm. So it's been, a bit of a wild emotional journey in the past 6 months.
I have another question.
Yep.
The most guilt that I feel and felt whenever I talk about not being in radio anymore, and I've kind of suggested over the past couple of rounds that I don't need to keep talking about it because I've found a way to talk about it most
things. And
you
were really good at talking about it straight out. Like,
yeah, I talk about it.
We had the same experience, but we reacted very differently.
Nah, not really, but I was mentally preparing for it. However, I feel selfish sometimes because I feel my situation is very different to yours because I was extremely lucky to not have to travel to cities that I didn't necessarily want to live in, searching for that dream job because, and I wouldn't say it at radio school, but I never really even wanted to be on the air, but I just ended up, it just happened, right? I don't know if I told you how I got on the air.
No, what, you were at Casanova, was that you?
Yeah, I was at Casanova, but I crashed the link van into power lines and the antenna fell down and I almost died because power lines came down. Yeah, it cost the company $150,000.
Wow.
And they said, hey, you can't drive the car anymore. Do you want to have a go on the air? And I'm like, yeah, all right. And that was it. That was literally it.
Yeah.
But I
quick. That's what. That was a quicker route than traveling around the country for
exactly.
8 years.
But my,
which I love, by the way. I don't regret any of that. But
well, can you tell me if this is accurate, that the disappointment can also be because you committed so much of your life chasing a moment, which was Adelaide, the city you wanted to live in, at the station you wanted to work in, and that moment, unfortunately, due to circumstances which are out of your control, was taken away. So that moment actually turned out to be shit in lots of different ways. Yes, a letdown. Yeah.
So you obviously start questioning whether I just wasted my entire adult life or something like that. Maybe I'm not good at it, or I don't know, you know?
Yeah.
So it was shit. Like, I think this is the week last year when like shit went down.
Yeah.
Like, it was the beginning of 2020, which was just a shit show. And the redundancy was just like what's the saying? Like, the straw that broke the camel's back.
Mm.
Like, there was plans to like travel and build a house and maybe have some kids. And
one hand in the bird, two in the bush or whatever.
That all crushed.
Great video, by the way, guys.
Yeah.
Check that one out.
What is it?
It's in the adult entertainment.
I know, I'm a child.
It's a longitude sub category.
I'm only watching PG. But no, I think, exactly that. Like, did I waste all this time away from my family and waste all these? I missed so many events, like just putting radio first and to just be told that. I know, like, they told us, you know, they blamed COVID or whatever. Mm. But it feels still like they lined you up, like, I don't know, ducks in the window of a Chinese shop and they, you know, shot down the ones they don't want. That's a weird analogy.
We've just got to stop saying sayings that I don't think exist. We're just saying
Nick's
stuff.
Metaphors are my skill.
I'm very good at that as well.
Andy once, we were walking to the gym.
Ducks up in a row.
This is the weirdest thing. We were once walking to Anytime Fitness on James Place, and Andy started telling this analogy. You remember it? Because
I had
to stop him and say,
and now you're using
mate,
it,
I'll
so
be honest with you, I've got no idea what the fuck you're talking about, mate.
Yeah, I used to say that a lot, even when I was on air.
kind of like go break your arm kind of stuff?
No, it was like, it was talking about, say, an old technology and a new technology, right? Yes. Say, radio and podcasting as an example. And I was like, so you're on one bicycle and that bicycle is quite old and a bit rusty. But then you have a new bicycle go past and it's brand new and it goes straight past. And it was something along the lines of that.
And I had... And he had a scoop of pre-workout before saying
that. Yeah, so I was like, bicycle.
You had this moment of, I have no idea
absolute,
what you're talking about.
Mind-blowing gym clarity.
Okay.
Wavelengths.
He was like, can
great
you just
podcast.
Go pump some iron and get this out of your system?
Yeah. And also went to the gym.
Yeah, well, Rosie, it's good to talk to you about it. I think there's a sense, everyone kind of has a sense of clarity as well, though, and it depends on the day, it depends on your mood, it depends on your perspective, right? So I think this time away from radio, because you'll be back in radio, there's no doubt about it, if you want to, which is another really important thing to add to that sentence, because you are in control of your future.
Yeah, I've been avoiding it. I've said no to opportunities. I don't want to do it right now.
But that's amazing, because how empowering is that to go, this isn't right for me right now? That doesn't mean you won't get a call again. However, the important thing is, and I sound like a dad here because I am, that what you're learning right now is research. You're learning how a person lives their life normally, how they consume media, how they consume radio. So when you go back in, then you can go, I've learned all this stuff, and you'll probably learn to go, I don't need to care about this thing, which means fuck all in the big scheme of things. Yes, you show you're passionate and you care, but it's not a life changer. Where there are several people who haven't been outside of the bubble or industry.
Mm-hmm. That and this can go for any industry, no matter what industry
definitely,
you're working, like radio or not.
Except like heart surgeons, because that's important. And you can't afford to go, that part doesn't matter. But I think you would, mate, Andy, you've been out for 18 months. So I'm sure you go, it's actually like... To be outside of it is a really good thing to understand life perspective. And I think that helps you continue your journey. It's weird. I would recommend some people lose their job in a circumstance, because it forces you to reflect and go, you're not bulletproof, but also like, what are we going to learn from this?
It's a mental reset.
Correct.
Yeah. And this guy, like, when it happened, I'm like, we could have had a whole podcast about different people being redundant in different industries last year, because that in itself is like this whole just shatters you, and you like have to go and do that self research, as you said.
Yeah.
You're like, what is important and what
who
matters?
Am I?
And who the fuck am I? Who am I? Why do people care?
It's who am I is a massive thing. To try and understand who you are really sets you up, though, because it gives you a bit of pride. Like, I reckon there were times that you go, I'm just going to say yes to everything reluctantly because A, I love my job. I don't want to lose my job. I want to make sure I'm doing the right thing, blah, blah, blah. But you're actually sacrificing who you are as a person, that other people in other industries, like my wife, who's a designer, will go, no, we put in billable hours. That's how we operate. Not just, I'm going to take one for the team because I'm serving a purpose.
Yeah.
So it's really interesting to look at that kind of stuff and to, as you said, like to understand who you are as a person, I think is a really powerful thing.
Without sounding preachy, like knowing your worth, because saying yes to everything doesn't promise you loyalty in the end.
Yeah.
And it's hard to talk about it post radio as well, to like we had this conversation just previously, to people that are currently in the industry, because you come across a negative. A lot of the takings home that I did from, say, the radio.
You took a lot of stuff home as well. Found that
fucking
you
don't need some stuff. I tell you what. I'm surprised they're still on air.
Correct.
You know, someone, remember that story Dave the PD told us about in the UK, where a guy would just start stealing stuff from the radio station, but he took one of the major components of the transmitter out of the like the IT area and just walked, went home. Like, I don't know, started his own station, I guess. Like, a bit of a pirate station. From the radio.
Suddenly,
game.
I have vision. I know what I want to do in 2021, guys. Someone have a boat?
Yeah.
Let's get ourselves
a boat. Also, we can weigh some scooters.
Yeah, headphones.
Headphones, bicycles, all sorts of stuff.
Sorry, but this guy just started. whole half the radio station was there.
Yeah, yeah, but off the back of the takings home from the Radio Game Changers podcast series that Jared features on with radio people that have left the industry.
Yeah, it's not Game Changers. It's basically I've been binned, what's next? Yeah. That's like, it's the watered down version.
Radio Game Bin.
Yeah, pretty much.
Sounds like a fun game on a Japanese game show.
Yeah. So once you're in the game and now you're in the bin. Yeah. Nima-san. I don't know. Is that a word?
I don't know. Just move on.
I feel like that's what they say in CG train. But anyway, you know when you walk in, they're like, Nima-san.
Yeah, they're not saying that.
Are they not?
No, they're not.
I've never tried to.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you're here.
I'm glad I'm here too.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah, it is good to have you here. It's good to learn about each other, learn about yourselves.
You know what, though? Like, when it comes down to it, not trying to sound like I'm giving you hugs and kisses and all that sort of stuff, but you guys are worth more than what you were dealt with in the actual industry. Just a heads up.
Well, I think discovering your own value and stuff, as I said, it's a pretty powerful thing. And ultimately, if other people or areas don't determine your value and go, no, they are irreplaceable, then that's their loss. So that will just, you know, that works.
The most amazing thing to me, though, is, and I discussed it with someone last week, the people that preach about mental health and stuff like that within the industry that are managers are the causes of the mental health issues that are within the industry.
I think it is fucking insane. I think that the mental health is not dealt with properly in that industry or any industry.
No.
Like, I've dealt with some shocking bosses. One who told me when I suggested I needed some time out because, you know, whatever my, you know, I was getting caught up in my own head, told me, and I think maybe you had a similar experience, Jared, that people would kill for my job.
And
how dare I ask for just a little bit of breathing time? And that's just one example, most recent, of like just them not dealing with mental health. Like, and they just handball it to those phone calls to people that you don't know. Like, and they just here you go, call this person, get better and come back. It's just, it's not dealt with well.
Yeah, it's a really tough thing to view. Like, you see with what's happening with the royal family at the moment, and I'm not really buying into it, but I've got this weird fixation on Piers Morgan, like I'm sure a lot of people do, to see. He plays the TV game really well and his role really well, but obviously he's walked away from his job at ITV over in the UK because he questioned Meghan Markle talking about her mental health and suicide.
Yeah.
So that was him crossing a line and he's obviously walked away from it. But what he doesn't realize is the social media brigade of people, they don't understand, like, you can't say to me, hey, I'm really struggling mentally today. And I can't say, all right, mate, prove it to me. Write it down. Show me all the factual stuff. Yeah. You can't do it. But there is a whole campaign.
It's not as if you walk in and say, I've got gastro. Okay, show me.
It's probably easy to call up when you're feeling shit and say, I have gastro, because they can deal with that. But if you call up and say, oh, you know what, my anxiety's got the best of me today.
You feel like their response is they're saying you're a pussy.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. There's someone that works in the industry that a former person on the radio had some problems mentally. And the question was, are they still right to go on air today? And you go, are you fucking serious? Like, people aren't equipped to deal with this stuff.
Yeah.
But I also...
Sometimes you can push through, but it's not going to help you in the long run.
That's exactly right. Yeah. So let's quickly move on to one more radio thing. We appreciate your honesty, Rosie.
Yeah. Good week for it with Markle. My God.
Exactly. Yeah. Radio ratings have come out today. Now, there's 8 ratings blocks a year.
Yeah.
And it's still done.
Is it weird that it's on a Thursday? Isn't it usually on a Tuesday, or is that just me?
I think so, but it was a public holiday in some areas on Monday.
Just A starting with T.
That's exactly right. Yeah. It's the first one of the year, so basically how radio stations finished up last year in December, then they've got to wait until March for the ratings to come out. So there's
the
very first one. And here in Adelaide, it was the very first one today.
Sure.
Promising.
No, I reckon it was the second.
First one.
I saw celebrations like a couple of months ago.
No, they were celebrating us leaving. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, they're like, we still got a job, guys. Yeah, celebrate.
So much money.
Yeah. So it's amazing having a look around at the different results. If you want to have a look at the results, you can go to the Radio Today website and stuff. We don't need to do a deep dive into it because there's different ways you can approach ratings. And I've always approached it of, I'll have a look, but then I'll go, it's the boss's job to worry about it. And we'll just do what we say, because everything that we are told to do was always reactive, basically, to ratings, good or bad, and it would be made to be like we're doing the wrong thing.
Reactive, not proactive, which it used to be.
Exactly.
For a period of time, it did really well.
Yeah, during a bad ratings, you just want the boss to get around you and go, like, come on, guys, you know, we're in this together. Look, it's not the greatest result today, but what are your thoughts? What can we do? So I wanted to talk to you guys, though, about some weird habits or rituals or how you prepared for it, because I just had a voice break.
Have you got a story, Jeremy?
No,
Dave, you remember Dave?
Yes.
He wore the same pair of undies and socks every ratings day.
You know why Jared knows that? Is because he'd sit next to the cubicle and Dave would take all his clothes off when he went to the toilet and you could see that on the ground.
All of his clothes, even the top off.
He was a nude dumper.
Yeah, because...
all nude.
Was it something that happened to him or a story that he heard about someone that wore, I think, overalls and they went to the toilet, did number two, and then put the overalls back on and they had a poo fall out and slap in the back of the head with the overalls?
In the workplace.
So they they were known as Nutella Head from then onwards.
I never came across Nutella Head.
He was on air for a bit. No, it wasn't someone in Adelaide. It was in the UK.
Yeah, it was a 9 and 9 with Nutella Head.
G'day, Nutella Head out of 7-4 here for the 9 and 9.
Here's your next nutty song. So have you guys had any weird experiences with ratings or how did you handle it? Because they really do determine the major kind of shows, future advertising, all that stuff, and it's still done by people ticking books.
Yeah, you know what? It was pretty sad a lot of the time when it was down. Because it was like it controls so many livelihoods, whether sales or programming or on-air teams and what sort of stuff. Like, you know, for them to get a roof over their head is to do with some, you know, stats that have been taken from one household.
Yeah.
You know, like...
I don't like numbers, so it confuses me. I'm like, if it just... Like, that book could be sent to one suburb, it could change to the next. Like... I know there's a theory and I just hate numbers, so I've never been like...
Yeah.
That's why podcasting is great, guys, because you get the actual numbers.
Yeah, you get the actual numbers. Tell us more, Andy. Tell us about poppetizing.
Yeah, poppetize. We can now do the whole world.
And what about poppetizing?
And also the world, yeah.
I like to celebrate when they were good. I would accept champagne in any case. But like more recently... I mean, Saturday day, if it was good or bad, I was never there for the celebration.
Yeah. Oh, you're always on air.
You're
really,
always on air. Yeah. And then they could be celebrating you upstairs, which is where the meetings of when they revealed the numbers, but you wouldn't know. You're like, I'm just going to keep on doing my job either way. So, like, I know some announcers took it personally. And I've met many.
Yeah, correct.
Yep. And so I had the thought, especially in work day when it wasn't really me on. Mm. I mean, I was on air and I tried to give as much of me as I could, but
that 12 seconds you're that you were limited, told to speak
yeah?
to.
Yeah, so like I wasn't going to go brag about a good ratings if they were good in the same way that I'm not going to go and wear the bad ratings when they're bad. Like I'm just going to see them, you know, accept them.
I guess you kind of got to look at it.
Do and keep moving
like
on.
Like the stock market, you're in for the long haul, right? So
you're
like
in for the long haul.
Yeah. That's why I didn't last that long on air, to be honest. Check out the headlines, Wozcast.
Use your right hand, make a fist.
Insert. Sorry?
No, I cut your sentence. Insert what?
Yeah, no, that's why I stopped.
Okay.
Inserted a rod into his left.
That's the boring answer. The fun answer is whenever you bring on a difficult day, I like to wear bright colours.
Yeah, no, fair enough. I like that.
Like I've turned up.
We used to have like really good celebrations when ratings went really well, but then it turned into like, what we've done today, guys, we've got some hot chips and you can come and get 7 if you want, but only 7, that's okay. And then like there'd be staff members that rock around and go, mate, did you eat your 7? Because I want to take some home for my kids and I'm going to say I'm bored.
Do you remember my going away? It was on the day before payday, so pre-payday pizza that was cold.
It was the same going away as someone who'd been there a lot longer.
Yeah, Jane Riley's going away. They got her a massive cake, and then they changed the name on the cake to mine that was half eaten.
And that was me.
And that was you,
I rearranged the letters.
Yeah, so you're very good to me, Rosie.
Can I talk about Jane Riley? I had a Jane Riley moment.
I love Jane.
So this is the story which leads into Radio Fails. So we don't need to play Radio Fails yet. But
before that, who talked ratings? Who came out number one?
So in Adelaide on the AM, it was the ABC breakfast.
Aren't they the only ones on the ABC? On the AM now,
5AA also number two, I think. As a whole, Mix 102.3 is the number one station in Adelaide. Ben and Liam, unfortunately for those boys, have moved moved down to last in FM breakfast. So Triple M above in front of them. SAFM are in front of them. SAFM had a really good book for Bet, Cozzy and Limo.
Wow.
So it's a pretty interesting time because I think Adelaide, in my kind of programming brain, Adelaide, as you know, is an older skewed market. And I think what's shown with the mix show, with Jody leaving and Aaron Phillips arriving, there's people still sticking with the station to hear how it sounds. But I also think people listen to mix because it's mix, not necessarily the programs that are on the air.
That's been the vibe for so many years. It's always been about because the music was that was their staple thing. Yeah. It didn't matter about the talent.
Yeah, yeah.
But the other stations who copy their ideas, so they're this sort of similar sort of thing,
yep.
is it's all about the talent rather than the music when they yep. should have been concentrating on the music
yeah.
and the talent.
Well, I think yep. it's going to be interesting because if that trend continues with, say, with Ben and Liam, if they stay where they are, I don't think they will. I think they've got a good product, but I think questions will be asked in regards to do they need more of a female presence on the show? Because they're two guys working together, and that obviously happened with Dylan Lewis and Shane Lowe. They brought in Hayley to have more of a female presence. And then also, are they hitting that mark of, yes, sometimes it's escapism to hear no child-friendly content and anything, but still an older audience, do you want stuff? I notice as a parent now, if I hear stuff on the radio in the morning that I think I don't want my daughter hearing that, I change the station.
I recently heard someone who was a mum in maybe, I don't know, age isn't important. She said she turned Will and Woody off recently because they were getting too risque for her kids, and it was like 4 o'clock in the afternoon in the car. Yeah.
If I was the group PD.
I'm not a parent, so I don't think like that.
But if I was the group PD of Ben and Liam, I'd be chucking them on Knights National. I wouldn't have them in breakfast. They're not appriate for breakfast. They're being held back. They're not their true person.
It's an interesting one because what will happen, I think, if their ratings are where they are consistently and the other shows grow continually, what you will find is their content will become more content directed to them as opposed to here's what you boys were known for doing your Triple J stuff where they got their really strong audience by having less restrictions, less contest spots around them, less interviews they have to do, partnership stuff. And remember, you work on Triple J, you don't have to do anything. Apart from
There's no business essentially, right?
No.
Speaking of Triple J though, today on the way in, I don't know what road up, it was the first time I saw like a bus.
First time I saw a bus? Well done.
Triple J. Have you ever seen Triple J advertising in the streets of Adelaide?
Not in Adelaide, no.
Yeah, it was like a full billboard on a bus stop.
Okay, sorry.
The microphone?
I passed wind.
Anyway, okay, thanks for the rating. Now back to Jane.
Yeah, so a couple of years ago, Jane Riley was at the Royal Adelaide Show. I was hosting and doing like an outside broadcast there, and this was back in 2005, I believe, and I interviewed Ron Moss from The Bold and the Beautiful. He was here in Adelaide, which is pretty cool, but unfortunately it was also the day...
Nonnies of Adelaide would be very jealous.
Correct. Steve Irwin passed away that day.
Oh, geez.
I was at the stage where I was emceeing, just getting ready to interview Jane, and I had to get on the stage and say, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to pass on some sad news that Steve Irwin has passed away because it was a big story and we thought it was appropriate to tell everybody. Jane didn't hear me saying that, so she stood behind me and was waving and poking her tongue out and pulling faces.
You can't hear from back there because of the in her defence because of all the...
But when I say behind me, she was literally standing a foot behind me doing that.
She should have heard you with her ears.
Yeah, correct. Yeah, she should have heard me with her ears. So I had to turn around and say, hey, Jane, look, I'm just letting the crowd know this, and she's immediately just deflated. So I had a moment like this on Friday, which it makes me feel sick. So I was at Adelaide United, and we were preparing for the game. Adelaide United. I did one of them on the weekend as well because I lost my voice.
Well done.
Thank you. So, and now it's become an internet thing where people are like, great game, and also Jared lost his voice again. Sick. So
I think it was branding.
Thank you. It is branding. Yeah. I mean, it's not great branding for a 37-year-old going through puberty. Yeah.
Goes through puberty.
Oh, should we get that guy that does the Adelaide? Like, to do the cricket? Yes, we.
a mutual friend who was working there, we were talking about a guy that we've worked with before who's a pain in the ass. And all he does is call. He just continually makes phone calls and we're like, nah, sometimes he's just really difficult to deal with. Mm-hmm. And as we were talking, he goes, he's calling me right now. I'm like, oh, wow. So I've walked away to do something and I've come back and he's on the phone and I've just started going, right in his face, like a kookaburra. So he'd start laughing and he turned away and walked off. And I'm like, yeah, he must be having a serious chat with this guy. Anyway, he hung up the phone and he said, hey, just to let you know, I hung up the phone on that guy about 10 minutes ago. That was my mum telling me that my grandmother has incurable cancer.
Oh, God.
And I'm going, and a good thing is you couldn't see my face because I was wearing a face mask, but it just dropped immediately and I felt sick and I apologised. But then the next morning I was listening to 5AA, to KG and Cornsy. Can you can we do a radio fail here?
Yeah,
fails.
So I was listening to KG and Cornsy.
Yep.
Listening to KG and Cornsy is like, it's like a podcast.
When were KG and Cornsy?
Years ago.
Years and years ago. So they've been on radio as a pairing for 30 years, right?
Yeah, but now?
Yeah, they're still on 5AA on a Saturday morning. But the bizarre thing is they only talk about footy.
Sorry,
they
really switched off.
They don't talk really about any other sport apart from football. KG just gets angry and they've got the same callers. So basically the same five callers every weekend. So it's like listening to a replay.
It's like a family dinner every Monday night.
Correct.
Yeah, that's right.
Correct. Cornsy stuffs up the buttons all the time. It's just, I don't know whether I listen because I love it or it's hilarious.
You're waiting for something to go wrong.
Correct.
Okay.
Kind of like this.
Rodney, you're still there?
Yes, I am, Graham.
Oh, I tried to get rid of you, but...
Yeah, no, you're right, mate. Look, a lot of people are trying to get rid of me, mate. I'll just to tell you, I've been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer, mate, that's incurable.
Sorry,
but
mate.
It can be contained, mate, and I'm gonna fight it. And one of my dreams are, mate, to wear that baggy green again. Well, not again, for Australia, mate, in the veterans cricket.
Oh, really? So, well, good luck to you.
I'm going to set myself that target, mate.
Good on you. So, we'll keep us informed.
Now, yeah.
So, first of all, Rodney pissed off we don't like you, and Rodney's gone, well, here's the thing.
Yeah. Mate, we're trying to get you off the face of this earth. Well, actually.
Oh, my. Yeah. I mean, that's a...
That's so bad.
That's horrendous.
Yep. So, were you listening out for radio fails? Did I only send you one, or did I send you two? I reckon I've just sent you the one.
Yeah, you sent me one.
We always like to listen out for them because they're everywhere. We're still yet to play the Essential Beauty one, which we might at one stage.
Okay.
People who have heard that on the radio, they know it's... Should I have even said Essential Beauty? I can say that, can't I?
I mean, you're not part of the company that was... Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, okay. Andy, what's been going on with you, brother?
We just got Essential Beauty on as a sponsor. what did you guys do on the public holiday on Monday?
Oh, gosh.
Because I didn't even realise it was one until Thursday because I'm no longer in that sort of like, let's go and get fucked up for Adelaide Cup Day.
No, I went hard on Saturday and Sunday, so Monday was recovery.
Me too, actually.
Even though every day is pretty much recovery.
I threatened to put my daughter in jail.
Did you?
Why?
Yeah, yeah. I've got my 4-year-old has a problem listening at the moment, so I've got an app which is the police. And it's, can I play this to you?
Yeah.
This is incredible. So for
is any, a governor, is like an English policeman.
No, no. Any parents.
You rise the old bill, innit?
Any parents who are listening and you want to kind of get your kid to start listening.
And this, have a problem with authority later on in life?
Well, I don't know, but this actually scares the shit out of my daughter. And I don't know if I've gone too far with this. So there's an app where I'll say, if you're not behaving, I'm going to call the police. She goes, no, don't call the police. So this is how it works. You open the app. When you open the app, it says kids police, right? And then you pick certain things. You go, okay, so I'm the father of a girl and I need a call for a naughty girl. Sounds a bit weird so far.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so this is how it sounds.
You put this on loudspeaker.
Hello, this is 911 emergency. How can I help you?
Yeah, my daughter, she's 4 years old. She's been a real pain and she's not listening, mate.
Okay, I will transfer you to the kids police station.
Thank you.
Just hold on a second.
Okay, we'll do. Cheers, mate.
You practiced this one.
Yeah, no.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
This is the kids' police station.
Thank you.
What is the problem?
Okay, my daughter's not listening to me. She needs to go brush her teeth. It's so annoying. Hello?
Okay, sir. Can I get her name and the age, please?
Yeah, her name is Rain, and she's 4 years old, okay? Almost 4.5.
Is she still crying, sir?
Yeah, she is. She's been a real pain in the ass. Stop crying.
Is she still doing naughty stuff?
Yeah, she is. That's a bit weird, right? Yeah.
Is this Pornhub?
Sir, if she doesn't stop, I will send an officer to help you right away.
Yeah, fantastic. I think you should. And then this time, Rain's going, no, no. And I'm like, quiet.
Is she still screaming and kicking?
Yeah, she's still screaming and kicking. And she goes, I'll be quiet, I'll be quiet, I'll be quiet.
Okay. I'm afraid that I will have to send an officer to her.
So that's as far as I've got. And then she gets quiet. She goes, I don't want to go to jail.
So it just keeps on going until keeps they going. Sort of
guys,
stop
app
it.
Idea. Can we make an Aussie one where we call 000? So definitely. When your child is in trouble, she won't call.
Got one of Santa, yeah. Got the Easter Bunny. It's amazing.
I know you've just had an accident, but I'm going to call the naughty police. Yep. Anyway, so, well, that's great for your Monday.
Thanks.
My Monday, I went to the zoo.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, with all the kids.
Did you just hang out and watch the pandas for, like, ever?
No, we didn't go see the pandas this time. Because what happens when you go to the zoo when you got kids, right? This is one thing I picked up on Monday, is that you look around and no matter the age, the sex, the income stream of the person that you're looking at, the parents with their kids, you're all on the same boat.
Correct.
You're all yelling.
Is that a nice feeling?
You know what? It's
we're all going down.
No, you're surviving.
It's a survival feeling. Like I acknowledge that everyone else is going through the same thing sort of feeling.
Yeah.
And you look around and it is that like, yeah, there's monkeys, there's lions. There's bloody, yeah, exactly. But the real zoo is in the paths where people are like walking with their kids and they're like, hey, what did you say you wanted to get? No, I can't do that. And then like there's just fights everywhere and
they're like, what do you want to see next? And they're like, the ice cream.
Yeah, that's
the
right.
Playground. Yeah.
Or you got dads obviously there by themselves with their kid and they're like just trying to keep their kid on in a good way. Like, okay, no, we'll go get an ice cream in a second. Yeah. Just shut the fuck up. And I'm there like,
the zoo.
And I'm there like, all my kids, can you please follow me? Like,
the Pied Piper's
yeah,
there.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, no, that was actually really good. But it was just a refreshing feeling when you look around. Yeah. It's the weirdest feeling ever.
Misery loves company, mate.
Yeah, it does. And we all had a lot of company there. it was like a big concert full of 40,000 people. And because it was super busy because it's a public holiday and yep. It was like the first time where the amount of people that were allowed in there, like it was bigger. So it was just action-packed and stuff like that. But something else that did actually happen that night is that we got home.
Great.
And that's it.
Yeah. And all the children arrived home as well.
You went back
well.
To your zoo.
Yeah.
We put those kids to bed. And then we sit out and Yaz is like, hey, you know how we're engaged? And I was like,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, no.
Who do you want to go to the wedding? And I was like, what wedding? We haven't planned one yet. She's like, I know. So, and she's like, when do you want to set a date? And I was like, oh, whenever. Like, when do you want to sit? Like, I'll be happy to go to Grenfell Street and do it now if you want. And she's like, so would I.
Oh, really?
And so we started looking at venues, right? She had a particular date in mind and it's because it's 22nd of Feb.
22nd of the 22nd, 22. Right? Yes.
Okay. And they're calling
it. Is your favourite number?
And it's a Tuesday, so they're calling it Tuesday. Like for next year.
Yeah, that's cool. That's cool.
So we're like, oh, fuck it, let's do that. Because it's Tuesday, it should be cheaper.
That'll cut the numbers down.
Absolutely.
I highly doubt it's going to be cheaper because that might be a frequent thing.
That's true. God damn it. It turns out this is a really bad idea. It's going to be very expensive. So we sat down, we started looking at venues and we found one that looked pretty cool, you know, something to do with us. It was like...
It was my mum's house.
It was something to do with us.
Like, ass. No, it was just a plate of potatoes, really, in Rundle Street that we could just kiss over. That's referring to an old story that Jared might let you in on one day.
Yeah, you ruined my night. Doesn't matter. Don't talk about it. I don't like to talk about it.
So we looked at the venue and we're like, wonder how much it's going to cost. And it was like X amount. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. No worries. Wonder if you have to pay like a deposit.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's generally what happens, right, with the venue. So we clicked next and they're like, congratulations, you've booked the venue. And
we're like, my God.
Fucking hell. So,
good news is there's no deposit needed.
So we're going to see on Friday to see if it's appropriate and work from there.
That's really awesome.
So,
after a hectic day in the zoo, you decided, you know what could be more hectic?
Yeah.
Let's plan a frigging wedding. That'll be easy.
Yeah, that should be
Bravo.
Good.
Bravo.
Yeah, good luck.
Yeah, a little box code can pay for that. So
yeah, all we'll say is good luck with that. Imagine that you've got, what have you got for lunch? A little box code I've catered for it.
Yeah, you know, that's what I'm
if you're on table 4, you'll have the Maltesers, and table 5, you will have those little Sakata crackers.
Don't downplay it. They're pretty good.
Okay, let's do the thing we announced last round. We launched the Shifty Sound and it was incredible, Rosie. You were part of it, but then the recording didn't work. But we have a Shifty Lizard voucher to give away with a brand new competition called
The Shifty Sound.
If you have had a guest during the week, hashtag The Shifty Sound.
Where can
sound.
I see them again?
Hashtag The Shifty Sound.
Ask the question just as
you were
telling
you. Were you bad at school with listening?
I'm bad at listening. Do you have the police app?
I certainly do. Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Do you have the actual sound there, Andos?
I do.
Okay, have a listen to this now. We played this last week. We are doing this alongside Shifty Lizard. They make incredible beers down south of the city and they want to give away a voucher. So pretty much we are going to take guesses online with hashtag The Shifty Sound. We are going to read out some of the guesses today and indicate if someone has won, and then I think we should drop a clue. I've got a clue for it because I think we're getting close. Here is The Shifty Sound. Do you want to hear that again, Rosie?
Yeah, how do you spell Shifty?
Oh my God.
Are you serious?
What,
S-H-I-F-T-Y. Are you looking on Twitter?
Oh no, I'm on Instagram, okay, guys. Okay. Play it again though, play it again.
Okay.
So last time I was here, I don't know if I was giving
last
it away.
Time, last time you were here,
but you stopped me talking
because
I said it sounds like flicking.
Oh, yeah, that's okay. Now
and
stop
you stopped
flicking.
Me.
Yeah, because you said flicking and it just sounded weird.
I thought I was getting close. Like flicking.
What do you mean? Stop it.
Yeah, every time you say it, it's worse.
Okay, so that was an accident. I hear what I said now.
Let's go through some of the guesses. All right, Cam Hawkins on Twitter. Is it dropping a donation cap into a jar at Grilled?
Good description, though.
I think he wants you to play it again, and then you play it, and then he says no.
You just play it. Okay, yeah.
Oh, okay, that's what he wants. Yeah.
At Jamie Manson, Matt's dad's dog collar tapping on the dog bowl.
Another good one.
Yeah, wrong. This is David. I saw David, actually, at the W League on
hello,
the weekend.
David.
Flicking a bottle cap with your thumb.
That's what I thought.
Josh Miller. Oh, yeah, it sounds better when David says flicking, though.
Yeah, so, yeah, he does. So, and he's doing it via word, like texting.
Josh Miller, dropping the ring pull from a can on a bench top. Jamie Manson's decided to have another guess, but even though I said kind of like just have one, a bottle opener.
No, no, no.
And Stu Becker, is it flicking, oh, God, a can ring pull once the can is opened? So there are some guesses we've had. Okay. They are all incorrect. We want to give this voucher away, so here is a clue.
That's
how I...
Oh, that's a bit racist.
Yeah, don't say that.
You can't say that.
That's an onomatopoeia, guys.
Go have a break in the corner,
Rosie. Onomatopoeia?
Onomatopoeia.
The toilet's around the corner. We've reset it all, the guests. We've reset them all because all of those are incorrect. Yep. Here is the clue. Remember... hashtag The Shifty Sound. We will go through the guesses next round and hopefully have a correct one, and we will give away that voucher to Shifty Lizard. Here is the clue for The Shifty Sound. Have a listen to it one more time. The clue is this.
Sorry.
It's not as confusing as you think. Once again, it's not as confusing as you think.
Does it involve a guy called Con?
Can't say. Okay. Oh, we're not allowed to comment on that.
Confucius.
Oh, that's the answer. Oh,
that's Confucius. There you know. So there you go. Have a think about it. Put all your answers on social media. Guys, let's do one of these games, which I've designed for you both, which I think is very funny. I don't know if we've got any generic game show music or anything, but it doesn't matter if we don't. Maybe you can play, you know that game we had with the 10 seconds last night thing? Is there a bed to that?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's just play that and just,
10 seconds.
10 seconds.
Yeah, 10 seconds.
10 seconds.
10 seconds.
Wow. 10 seconds.
10 seconds to what?
It's last night in 10.
It's not really.
Was that all your voices? That's your whole vocal, like
we all got into the studio booth and recorded together at one time.
Cartman got in there. It was amazing. So, guys, this is a game that I have designed between Andy and Rosie will play off against one another, and it's called the Google game, right? So I am going to type a question into Google.
Yes.
And then you know how the autofill works. Yes. There are 10 particular things that happen on the autofill. Mm-hmm. So if you guys get one of them, you will get points in regards to the ranking. So if yours is the 10th most popular search, you will get a 1 point. You're guessing what the sentence is, all right?
Sure.
So there are five of them, and you both get a guess each.
And you need to keep your eyes over here because you're on the side of the laptop. So you just...
You can't see it now.
Okay.
So I have just typed into Google...
What, you just want to stare at you?
No, don't do that either.
That feels weird.
Sorry, Chris. Sorry.
It's going to be very weird when I ask this. Question one. How do I get rid of...
Lice.
Rosie says lice. Andy?
A scab.
No, you both don't get a point. So,
here we go again.
So the top answer was fruit flies, split screen on iPad, hiccups, a sore throat quickly, belly fat, pimples, blackheads, stretch marks, bed bugs, ants.
Well, they're all Jared's guesses.
Does this reflect on you or on the world?
Yeah. I don't know.
I think it reflects on your region.
Okay, this is one of my...
your down region.
Well, speaking of which, question two, this is one of my most regular search things. I have a rash on my...
I'm going to just go straight out there and say groin.
Groin, Andy?
Penis.
On your penis?
Yeah, I'm right on it.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Sorry, I don't have one.
Okay. Both of you are incorrect.
Damn it.
So I have a rash on my neck, face, chest, stomach, thigh, breast, back, forehead, butt cheek, back that itches.
But you said it was what you write in there.
Okay, the next one. The next one. The score is 0-0.
Ah, good times.
I don't know how to...
Read.
I don't know how to ride a bike.
Both incorrect again. I don't know how to love him. I don't know how to love him chords. I don't know how to love. I don't know how to love him lyrics. I don't know how to talk to you. I don't know how to feel. I don't know how to feel love lyrics. I don't know how to dress. I don't know how to cook.
No, this is your history.
What are you Googling?
I'm Googling exactly them. All right, there's two to go. Oh, this is a great one.
Yeah, one of us should get a point.
Yeah.
How do you spell...
phlegm.
Ooh.
That's a good one.
That's a good one.
There.
You are both incorrect. How do you spell beautiful, favourite, auntie, definitely, colour, Christmas?
Definitely, I always screw that up. Yeah. I should have known that.
February, pneumonia, and the last one, jail in Australia.
Which is G, kids.
Okay, the last one.
Okay. Let's see if one of us gets a point.
Last Everyone's one. A winner.
My feet smell like...
curry.
My feet smell like...
Can I give you another answer?
No, wait.
All right.
Vomit.
You both are incorrect, so you will be able to have another guess.
Okay, go.
Wet towels.
My feet smell like ass.
Like all of us, or?
Can we go again?
Like bum holio?
One of us needs to get an answer.
I'm just Googling what something is, just to check.
Okay. What did you say? Curry?
No, the second one was wet towels. Oh,
okay. Andy, you're very close, but you are both incorrect. You get another guess. Oh.
You go first.
B.O.
Oh, what else could your feet smell like? Cheese.
Damn it, I reckon you're a winner.
I'm going to accept one of them, and I will go through the answers right now. My feet smell like Google Feud answers.
Okay, that's dumb.
Apple cider vinegar. What? Fritos. Popcorn.
That's ammonia. Dog's feet. Ammonia.
Bread. Mildew. Garlic. Dog poop. And I'm going to give this one as a winning guess, Cheetos.
To who?
To you. You said cheese.
Oh, yeah.
Well done, Rosie. With 1 point out of a possible 100. All right, guys, let's do some radio fails before we go into our Back to the Future quiz. There were not radio fails, sorry, Sexy Sam, not radio fails.
Yeah,
radio
I was like,
well, it's the same thing anyway.
Is it?
Sexy. Sad.
Now, we had this whole chat about Sam Tugwell last recording that didn't record Rosie. So Sam Tugwell works at 5AA. You said he was a hottie last time we spoke to him.
I don't think I said that. I mean, Sam, I mean, saying you're not, but you said that.
Yeah, I did say that. And he has a podcast called The Press Box Ep. He does a Sunday show with Ken Cunningham, or Ken Cunningham KG. And KG calls him Tugger. He's like, yeah, good one, Tugger. It's
no, what was the other one? The Love Tug or something?
He's a romantic Tugger.
Oh, that's it, yeah. The Love Tug.
Yeah, so what we've noticed, though,
that's
whenever...
not a good nickname.
Whenever the Press Box Ep, which is a hard-hitting sport...
And his show called Press Box, and his nickname is Tugger. I mean, jeez.
So, you have the right frame of mind to be on this podcast.
Exactly. So he does a hard-hitting sports podcast where they only talk about sport. But what Sam doesn't realise is that he's accidentally sexy in some of the things that he says. Mm-hmm. We found two from the latest episode of the Press Box Ep with Sam Tugger, Tug Very Well, Tugwell, Dale Dustin Fletcher, and Jace Sean Kemp. And sometimes Jack Anthony, Paul Hudson is on there as a guest.
Is that one person?
Yeah, I'm just throwing some names together. Yeah, hyphenated.
He got married a few times.
He did, yeah.
How progressive. He took all these ex-wives' names. Yeah. That's nice.
This is the bombshell which we teased on social media, that this could rock the foundations of the Press Box app, because I need to say the word allegedly. If you listen to this sentence from the Press Box app, it really highlights an allegation that Sam Tugwell may be seeking a particular type of love from a particular type of road, and I'm suggesting it's Hanson Road.
Are you saying paid Tug?
Well, let's find out with Sexy Sam.
Thanks for your services. Hopefully we don't have to see you again too soon.
Sexy. Sad.
You're like, you're really reaching right around for that one.
How do we get to Hanson Road?
Well, just have a
I know what happens on Hanson Road.
Okay, so this potentially is the last thing that Sexy Sam said after the service was conveyed.
This is such a stretch.
Can you play one more time?
Thanks for your services. Hopefully we don't have to see you again too soon.
Sexy.
So you're saying that he's putting out for cash down there?
Well, I'm not too sure. I'm not going to make any more allegations. However, we did manage to find in the same podcast there was another member who just decided. I think he got a bit jealous. He wanted to be just as sexy. Don't say member when we're talking about Sexy Sam. But today it's not Sexy Sam. Have a listen to this.
Depends how long you want to milk it, Tuggers.
Sexy Dale.
It's a kinky one.
It really is.
It's a very kinky one. Guys, let's do the Back to the Future quiz before we go. This is where I test you both. It was great last round. No one heard it.
Have you ever been part of this game? Or was you always the quiz master?
No, I like to be the quiz master. Okay, that's fine. I think it's a really important thing. It showcases how good you guys go against one another and you work well with one another. And what I'm doing right now is called padding in the business, Rosie. Because I'm
seamless. I couldn't tell.
I actually had it on there and it's disappeared.
Yeah. There was a guy that I used to work with in Melbourne. He now works in Hobart. His name's Dan Taylor or Launceston, and he padded for 3 minutes because he timed out incorrectly to go to network. So he played the Monkey Magic theme. On Nova 100, played the Monkey Magic theme and went through his favourite characters.
That's amazing.
I remember, who was it? Steph. Mike and Steph, when they did Night
Scene. They were not Monkey Magic characters.
No, they weren't.
I remember Steph. She was my favourite. Yeah.
Wasn't Steph on that princess show? Remember that show where they made everyone into a princess? Like they were like a bit rough and they get them in there to turn into a princess.
The ugly swan.
No, that wasn't it. Oh. Anyway, it was like some sort of princess school. Anyway, she used to just play Nova IDs for a minute.
Yeah, good.
So be like, Nova 919. More than two hours in a row.
And she kept her job. Well,
for a short period of time. Anyway, he's... Yes.
Okay, guys. This is it. Nervous about this one. Andy,
back in the future, I found out last week that Lena from the Brighton Trophy Centre used to be the voice of IKEA.
No way.
What, the get in the car?
No, internally.
Stop looking at me. What is it? Not happy.
That's Yellow Pages, but whatever.
Same, there's a yellow themed IKEA. No,
so what happened is, so she worked in the back end of the store, and the front end as well.
It's such a visual moment that we get to enjoy when he says back end.
But she...
Are you still recording? Yeah, yeah, of course you are. Sorry.
So to become the voice of IKEA internally, so that was the people that would speak on the PA.
That's sick.
And the closing stuff at the end, and also maybe the ads as well.
Yeah, I love that.
You had to do like a full blown like audition process, and they had a studio built out the back just for this sort of stuff.
Did she have to sound Swedish?
No, because it was the Adelaide version of IKEA, so it was just be yourself, hey.
Be yourself, hey. Come check out our
is
Lego.
Is that still a job? Because I'm still looking for gigs. So.
No. As you would know, she now works at the Brighton Trophy Centre.
Yeah.
So that means the IKEA job.
You could go and review their hot dogs and meatballs for the, I've had heaps of bad food, now I need to go for a jog podcast that you're on, yeah.
There are fresh meatballs in the food court. Yeah. Anyway, let's play this game.
All right, Andy, I need access to your computer here because I'm going to play some sound effects in this. So you need to please press stop on this music. Guys, good luck. This is, as you know, 10 questions. Your name is your buzzer. Please test your buzzers.
Rosie.
Andy.
Very good. Very good. They're working very well. Okay, guys, let's go into it. There is some audio in this quiz.
Okay.
And the first one, what is the name of this TV show?
This is 29 Acacia Road.
Rosie.
Rosie.
Banana Man. Banana something.
Yeah, she's got it. She's got it. Well done.
My favourite show, right next to Super 10. I think they played back to back.
Yeah, I remember that now. I don't remember that, though.
What a great show.
Hey, feel free to eat while you're recording as well, Jared. Cool.
Can I leave it? Shh, listen.
Please welcome Rosie Panetta.
Epic.
Great work. Rosie's on one and Andy on zero. Question two, name the show that Michael J. Fox starred in.
Andy. Fucking don't know. Family Ties
is correct. I would have also accepted Spin City. He was also very good.
Yeah. I never watched that.
Okay, great. Finish the line to this song. What is the next line?
Andy.
Oh, I was going to sing it. Damn it.
5, 6, 7, 8.
I think I got that backwards because this was what I was supposed to play. Mine, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, well done. You got it right.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, Andy is on 2 and Rosie is on 1. Question 4, who was the host of the ABC's The Afternoon Show?
What, say that again?
ABC's The Afternoon Show on television.
What afternoon show?
He is a famous radio broadcaster. His first name, Michael.
Was there like a kid show? Or?
Yeah. He used to throw to like Degrassi and stuff. Don't know.
Oh, no. No.
Okay, I'll get that one. Jared Michael Tunn.
Can I Google his face for some nostalgia while you ask the next question? I can multitask maybe.
Question 5. Who was the breakfast show that launched Hit 107?
Andy.
Oh. Yeah.
What was the question?
The breakfast show that launched Hit 107.
I should fucking know this.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no, I've had a blank on the bloke. I know who the girl is because I really wanted the gig. 5. I got really annoyed that 4. They gave Was it Danny?
Danny is correct.
And the bloke who was probably doing a show with a fringe right now, and I feel really rude that I've forgotten his name. And I met him and I sat in their show for like a whole week.
Don't need your life story,
Amos,
mate.
Danny,
you get half
Amos.
A point each, half a point each. Okay, so Andy on 2.5, Rosie on 1.5, question 6. Who won the AFL Grand Final in 2004?
Andy?
Yeah.
Sydney?
Incorrect.
I don't want to answer this question because I'm really good at making
Andy?
Idiom.
Andy?
Geelong?
Incorrect.
West Coast?
Incorrect.
Andy?
Yeah?
The West Coast Mariners?
Incorrect. You don't get any more guesses.
Is it a home team?
Yeah, it was Port Adelaide.
Port.
Yeah,
okay,
Port
Adelaide.
You work for them. How did you not know that?
I
read scripts only.
Of course.
That's only because.
Question 7. What is the dog's name in Back to the Future?
Michael J. Fox. No.
I'm still just living the last question and feeling really bad about
Incorrect.
It.
Incorrect. Einstein. Question 8. Name 2 of the occupations of the village people.
Rosie.
Yeah.
Workman.
Mm-hmm.
And very politically incorrect, Indian.
Ooh, what type?
What type?
No, guys.
Native Indian.
Native American Indian. Okay.
Question nine.
He's gone off the rail, guys.
What was the guy's name who was your number one friend on MySpace?
Andy.
Oh. Andy.
Tom.
Yeah, good. This is the last question. Which band sings this song? I can't
deny. Oh, Andy.
Andy.
I mean, why don't I just ding myself? Is it human? No, no, no.
Oh, you're going to go human nature. That's what you're going to say.
No, I was going to say that. Darren Hayes.
I had a dream about you and Darren Hayes.
That's why I wanted to bring it up.
Darren Hayes was singing and Andy was there going, no, I haven't pressed record, guys.
Really? Really?
Recently?
Fully clothed. Yeah, what? 2 nights ago, I messaged Andy about it.
Yeah, when you sent the message, I thought it was going to be something like a bit sexy.
Anyway.
But, anyway.
I'm going to say Westlife.
Westlife? Incorrect. I can't deny what I believe. What I believe. I can't be what I'm not. No, no, no.
Ronan
Keaton's in this one.
Westlife.
I said that.
Oh, wow. Said that.
NSYNC.
Nope.
No, it's a British guy. It's a British group.
Oh, my God.
And I got to press stop because we'll get copyrighted.
Yeah.
Did you say Boyzone? Correct.
Yay! So who won?
It was definitely you.
Yeah, you definitely won. Well done.
Yay! Point.
Rosie, thanks for joining us. Follow
thanks
us on the socials at Best Team Men. You'll be back.
Worked this time.
Hashtag the shifty sound. Thanks for listening. It's been an extended episode today, which has been great because of what happened, but we're glad to have you here, Rosie. Thanks for your honesty. And basically what happens now is I just dribble shit and talk, and then but we get to a point where I stop talking because the man from the Brighton Trophy Centre, his name's Con, he takes over with the rap. It sounds like this. Brought to you by the Brighton Trophy Centre. Cups, trophy, badges, medals. Yeah, we do it better. Best team, man. BTC, BTM, BTS. Yeah. Best team, man. Oh, yeah. Sweet. Oscars. Nurses, we just want to thank you for everything you do. We are ShiftKey.com. Log on today and connect to open PRN shifts in your area. Work when you want, where you want. You can even get paid next day. ShiftKey.com. Start today.
Love this podcast? Support it and sponsor today. Simply head to OzCastNetwork.com for details.